chairman at this time. When I accepted the role of program chairman for the second year reluctantly, I was promised a lot of help by the powers to be, and help I got. We've had everyone from Eleanor Roosevelt to an acupuncturist. We danced to a German band at Oktoberfest. We had tea and crumpets at our high English tea. We had learned how to attract bluebirds even if we didn't want to. And we were entertained at a business meeting conducted by some of our children and our grandchildren, and were emotionally moved during a program by some life-sized puppets who taught us about autism. But that was then, and this is now, and I think we probably saved the best for last. It's with a great deal of pleasure that we present to you Fashions in Music, starring members of our Crete Women's Club Chorus, in a 20-year review, and your hostess for the evening is Rosemary Foley, and she's bending.
Thank you.
Good evening. We thought that was appropriate music to sing tonight. What the World Needs Now was one of our first songs. We sang it over 20 years ago, and it sounds like a theme we could use again today. So nothing really has changed that much in 20 years. The chorus has really been together since January was the 21st year of this year. And the reason we remember, see, if we ever have a fight about when we started, I can always end it. Because I can say, don't tell me, I came in January feeling very sick. Every time we rehearsed, I was sick. And then Patrick was born the following September. So we just know that when Patrick hits 21 in September, we started 9 months before that. So we always ask, anytime Sue wants to know, how old, now what year is this? She always says, how old is Patrick? And then we just figure back from there. So I have the solution. We started, as she said before, I'm Rose Marie Foley, so I didn't introduce myself. I am one of the original chorus members, as I told you. There were 13 of us when we first started. We still have 9 of us are left. Does that tell you something about stick-to-itiveness? In over 20 years, we've gone through a lot together. We've been through marriages and middle life and mini skirts and menopause and midlife crises and a whole lot of music. In choosing selections for the program tonight, it was really difficult, almost an insurmountable problem, because we had so many choices to make. Sue has a whole basement full of music that we've sung, literally hundreds of songs that we have sung for hundreds of organizations over a period of 20 years. And I got this job because I said last year when we got these outfits, gee, it would be interesting to see the things that we've worn over the last 20 years, and suddenly I was appointed chairman. So I think you'll find it interesting. This is a little review, and we're going to put in a few anecdotes as we go along. I'd like to introduce, first of all, Ethel Pearson, who is an original chorus member. Patriotic. Sue thought we looked like a bunch of peasants. husband have, believe it or not, 7 children and 6 grandchildren, and she calls herself a working mom, but she spends a lot of time volunteering for the International Order of Choristers. She does a great job. She sings alto with the chorus. Thank you, Carol. Now the chorus is going to sing another one of our golden oldies, Hey, Look Me Over.
Two sons and a daughter and 2 grandsons.
I have to tell you that Sue has that same dress as beige. And she just begged to wear it tonight, but I shook my head. You heard how singing broadens one down. I wanted to mention that we rehearsed at a lot of different places, and we've had to keep moving, I'm afraid, to keep ahead of things. But we first had our rehearsal space at the Crete Reform Church, the little round church here on Exchange that now is an office building. And then we moved to the basement of the Crete Bank, and at that time even the Women's Club was having their programs in the basement of the bank. And when they needed space, we all had to get out. So from there we went to the Crete Methodist Church, and we were there for several years until somebody asked us to come over and sing and practice at St. James. It probably was Our Ladies, maybe from the, Sue Hines, maybe that. Someone invited us over there. And we were there for at least a year or two until we ran into a problem. There was one lady in the back in a wheelchair. And every time Sue would give us directions and everything, she always say, "When are you gonna sing?" And that would keep up all morning. And so we decided that maybe we had better move.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm having trouble. Anyway, we are back at the Crete Methodist Church, for better or for worse at this point. One of the highlights of all our performances has been the chorus rendition of One, and we have a very famous performer with us
who does this. It's Betty Raddus.
There we go. Betty Raddus has been a chorus member for 11 years. She sings alto. She has two children, a boy graduating from high school, and an 11-year-old daughter, and we remember her bringing that 11-year-old in a baby carrier to many a rehearsal. She's an ex-school teacher, and she always is a hit when she performs One with the chorus.
Thank you.
introduce next Martin Berger, who is wearing that long, that black sweater this time, remember, from the red plaid skirt. She's wearing it with the white pleated skirt that we added to it. We wore this one time singing for the Lions Club, and one of the Lions said, "We look like a bunch of nuns." Or it was either a bunch of nuns or a bunch of penguins, I forget.
Polyester. president of the club. She and Len have two married children, and I should say two married daughters and four grandsons. Now Shirley, you should come out here again because, yes, come out here once. Because she wanted me to tell you that you wouldn't believe that, well, her mother always reminds her you're a healthy looking girl with someone who weighed 4 pounds at birth. I also want to tell you that when we wore all those pink, those long dresses, Shirley had one in pink. And when we went to the nursing, I was nursing, it was a retirement home her mother was in. Her mother was so proud. She just went through everyone and said, "That's my daughter Shirley in the pink." We sang a lot of Christmas music, and we just want to give you one little glimmer of someone who always is a standout. Marilyn Gottlieb as the monotone angel. Sometimes more of us than there are of them. The size of the group then varies greatly. We always seem to have someone in the back of the room at Christmas time who's had one drink too much and always wants Sue to say, "Oh, holy night." It's just a given. We know someone in the back is going to say, "Oh, holy night." With their flirtations and murmurings in the corners. We've seen them fall asleep. We've heard their teeth click. We've listened to dropped dishes. We've been there when they cleared the table. Sometimes they have sat through Christmas programs and cried, sobbing right in front of us. Now, Sue always tells us that shouldn't upset us when they cry. It's kind of good for their psychic, she figures. It doesn't do a thing for ours. We've sung at country clubs, in gymnasiums, in church basements, in churches, in church halls, in schools, a variety of restaurants. In fact, in many restaurants, our rear ends are right on the table. Tommy said, "It's true. It is true." We've even been down to Chicago a couple of times and sung at some of the big hotels. We've gone down to Champaign, Urbana, and sung for a convention. And you know the best part of everything? Usually they ask us back again. Our next group of models is wearing, well, Marge Huberger and Ginny Eichemeyer. And they're wearing green blazers with navy blue polyester skirts and navy blue striped costumes. I really like these outfits. I think they're kind of cheery. It's a lot, but everyone kind of hung on to it. You know, we all look quite smart in them. You've met Marge and Ginny before, but Polly has been a chorus member for 10 years and she sings for soprano. She's a former teacher and past president of the Harvey South Holland Women's Club. She and her husband Pete have 4 sons and 9 grandchildren. And it was mentioned before during the meeting that Polly is going to receive the Woman of the Year Award from the Council of Catholic Women on Saturday at the Cathedral in Joliet. That's a great honor. We're really proud of you, Polly. It's wonderful. Thank you, girl. Well, again, we recite part of that outfit. And here comes Clara Mae Zaslavsky and Laverne Slider. And they're showing a little sweetier version of the green jacket and the navy blue skirt. And it has changed it to white blouses with these floral ties. Both of these girls now are original chorus members. Clara Mae is the past president of the club. She's second soprano and a parent of 1 son and 1 daughter. She has 3 grandchildren. Tells me there's another one on the way. Originally a Johnson, Clara Mae was widowed and recently married John, and now they winter in Florida. But we don't let her go until after the Christmas programs are sung. And she and John both enjoy golf, and she's an excellent golfer. Very good. Don't let her place any bets with you when you go out to play golf with her. Laverne, she's the other one I agree. Laverne Slider sings alto, and she was originally with the Laurels, which is a singing group in Crete. She and Shirley Murray were in that group together. She's a member of the Methodist choir. She and her husband Bob have 3 children, but I don't know how many grandchildren. Laverne? 4 grandchildren. The family is very musical. Bob Slider, you remember, was with Crete Monique. And their son is a very successful musical composer in California, does some television work. And the only trouble with Laverne has one fault. She travels all the time. So we have to get her in the course when she's back. Thank you, girls. You look lovely in those. before us, and for one reason or another have found it necessary to drop out. Paula McGrath has won, Connie Nyum, Sandy Kaufman, Kelly Travis, Sue Zella, Dorothy Manwary, Dorothy's here tonight, I did see her, Bernice McDonnell, Leah Ray Leavernix, Sandra Setchel, and Sandra is here, I've seen her, Rosemary Salata, and Joan Fisher. And anytime these girls want to come back and sing, we just love to have them. I think they had good excuses, but we didn't like it. Well, speaking of former chorus members, we couldn't let this lady leave the chorus without doing her very famous number. So here is Ellen West, and Ain't She Sweet.
Right hand man here, right?
We all came to all the rehearsals, and all the performances, but it would be a good idea, I think. They both sing in the Methodist Church Choir, and she's really a good sport because the pianos she's encountered have had missing keys, they're out of tune. We had one that had a whole leg missing. It just one leg on one side. The worst was one that was on the upright, but instead of a spinet, it was higher. The whole top of it, except for the back here, was gone. There was no music stand, there was no front to the music. She really had to improvise. Sometimes we had broken piano benches, and on more than one occasion, we'd run all over looking for telephone books for her to sit on. Another time we've been there and they had a keyboard instead of a piano. So you never know when you walk in what this woman is going to have to do to create some music for us. So we depend very heavily on her and we appreciate her very much. I also want to mention that Tommy is from Hazelcrest, and through her influence she was able to bring in two new members into the chorus. And I don't know what the occasion is, but both of them have been missing tonight. That just was a coincidence. One is Char Lawson, and she directs a choir at the Methodist Church in Hazelcrest. And Zelda Bogash is also from Hazelcrest, and she has to be on vacation tonight. So they are missing. I'd like to introduce now the next three chorus members wearing some outfits in teal green that we got through the Lands End catalog. So if Ruth Vanderswag and Cheryl Kramer and Dorothy Whitman would come forward, they can show you off these little numbers.
I wrote my mother. She's an organizer, and she's funny. And tonight, she's running the show. I'm talking about Rosemarie Foley, wife, mother of three, grandmother of three. She's an opera buff, and she and Ben love to travel. How she finds time, I don't know. She has served as a director of the Heritage Bank and Country Club Hill, the director of the Park Forest Singers, the IPO, which is the Illinois Philharmonic Orchestra, and the Prairie State College Foundation, from which she just retired this last week. She's the past president of the Crete Women's Club and an honorary member. Currently, Rosemarie is in her second term as president of the Crete Public Library District. Do you think she's busy? At this moment, she was hiding back here because she's getting ready to set the mood for the arrival of one of your favorite Christmas chorus characters. Here's Marilyn, the pretty little dolly.
Grandchildren aged 2 to 23 years.
She's also a past president of the Women's Club. Now, I asked these gals if they wanted to guess. We got these last April, these dresses, and some of you have not seen them. So I asked them the other day how many times they thought we had worn them since last April. And we got all sorts of guesses, but I'll tell you, tonight is the 18th time we have worn these dresses, and by June we will have worn them 21 times because we have more performances to do. So when we come begging for more clothes, you know why. I don't think there's anything in your wardrobe that you've worn 18 times in a year or 20. I want to set the stage now for this next number, which we have added just recently to our performance, and Betty Raddatz is just terrific as Sweet Georgia Brown. Oh. She's always got a smile. She's really very special. special to all of us. She holds us all together. She really is the glue of this chorus. We wouldn't be here if it wasn't for Sue. I'd like to introduce our president, Bibbitt, who wants to say a few words just before our what we call our grand finale.
It is a great honor for me, Sue and Tommy, to, on behalf of the Greek Women's Club, to present to you these flowers as a warm, loving thank you for the joy you brought to us all, and into many other lives also besides the club, by your dedication to music. So, for 21 years, you have been the heart and backbone of this chorus. Thanks for holding the ties of togetherness and for making it such fun for the original and new members alike. Tommy, without your talent, happy, go lucky, and warm personality, this chorus would certainly be what it is today. Thanks a lot to the whole club.
And if your gals that aren't here, someone would need one for them.